Once upon a time, there was a seminary on the mountain. And in that seminary, lived a group of monks who were led by their master. Now, every time these monks faced a problem, they ran to their master, and the master used to solve their problems. Now, one day, the master decided that he will go down to the mountain, but he left a box behind with an instruction that in case they find a problem, they will also find a solution to that problem in their box. So on one day, it did happen that the monks faced a problem. So very confidently, they ran to the box and very eagerly they opened the box. But they were surprised to see a mirror inside the box. They were so much surprised that one of the terrified monks believed that it was a magical mirror. But ultimately, their surprise ended when they saw an inscription just beneath the mirror stating, "Face yourself for the solution." Now, each and every time the monks face this problem, they approach their master and the master used to find the solution for their problem. But in the process of finding the solution, the monk also taught them how to solve a problem. So, what I believe that this is the best way to describe what it means to be a leader. The basic purpose of putting that mirror inside the box was to make the young monks understand the true abilities which lies within themselves. A true leader is responsible for awakening, for opening up the hidden talent that lies deep within ourselves and to put it into the practice to ensure the maximum productivity out of us. Once a father took his daughter to the park. He wanted to teach her how to ride a bicycle. Now, initially, when she got the bicycle, she was not knowing how to ride the bicycle. So, of course, the father had to teach that particular girl how to ride this bicycle. So, he had to hold the bicycle for several hours. But in the process of holding the bicycle from the back, he ensured that she knew that his father was holding the bicycle. Of course, this instilled a sense of confidence, a sense of comfort deep within herself, so much so that when he finally let off the bicycle, it was him who had to run after the bicycle to catch hold of her. Now, in this situation, the father faced greater difficulties in teaching her daughter how to ride a bicycle rather than his daughter faced how to ride the bicycle while she was learning from her father. So, in other words, leaders have greater responsibility than the followers. And the leaders have to follow the qualities of patience, understanding, faith, as well as motivation to discharge their responsibility as leader. A true leader is the one who will take the bicycle all throughout the way. He will give his people a sense even when the bicycle faces a hurdle, it balances itself. The leader is the one who will take the bicycle to up to the point, till the point they find their own balance. Mike Tomney once very famously said that leadership is more about taking responsibilities rather than making excuses. This is the difference which lies between a leader and the follower. The leader has more responsibility. A leader is the one when he faces the obstacle, he faces the obstacle head on. A problem which is faced by someone who is under some leader, it doesn't remain the problem of that person alone, but it goes on to become the problem of that leader as well. And that is why we speak about great leaders like Nelson Mandela, who made the problems of all the African people his own problem. That is why we talk about people like Mr. Hollande, the French president, who took responsibility of 30,000 Syrian refugees. Because these personalities, these great leaders, they deep within themselves felt the great responsibility of the troubles faced by all these people. At Parul University, this is the kind of great desire, great drive that lies within each and every teaching and non-teaching staff of Parul University. A kind of quality leadership which we gracefully want to impact our students. Recently, a symposium called Confluence was organized by the students of Parul Institute of Medical Sciences and Research, which not only acted as a medium to teach them the sense of responsibility, but also taught them what leadership is all about. They not only learned about their responsibility for the hospitals as well as the patient, but it also taught them social leadership by various elements of life such as dance, drama, acting, music, literature, and many other medical aid initiatives. So in all, what I believe is we are not born as leaders in the same way we are born not knowing how to ride a bicycle. So leadership is to be learned, and it cannot be learned by going right into the front, but it is learned first by being the true follower. And at the end, I would say a moment when you take responsibility of anyone and everything, you tend to become leader for everything and everyone. Thanks a lot.